Hi, all my crafty friends. This is Patty from A Soul's Heartbeat. I know I've been missing in action. This virus thing has just sapped all my creative juices, I guess. So I wanted to share with you something I had done, and I have been doing some things, I just haven't been filming them. My niece's birthday is today, and I wanted something really special for her, and I have this pre-made journal that I had in my stash. It's a ledger. I think it's a Seven Gypsies. And this is what it looked like. It came like this, spiral bound. And I'll show you the papers in it in just a minute. And then I'll show you how I've altered some of them. Didn't do the whole book because this is kind of a give and you decide book. I don't know how else to describe it. I'm going to give it to her today. Well, I'm going to put it on her front porch, ring the doorbell, and wave from the driveway. My 6 feet distancing, you know. But I'm going to give it to her and then let her decide how she wants me to finish the rest of it. So what I've done is I made a belly band. I saw Manuela Bunny Bow. She did this on one of her journals with something similar to this, and I thought, ooh, what a neat closure. This is elastic. I have, in fact, this top little butterfly came from Manuela in a gift pack, oh, eons ago, and so did the lace behind it, and I just tea-dyed it, and I think I used distressed inks, really. It was a white. And so I have this elastic, and it just goes around this like this to hold it, and it comes off. So as it gets alligatory, it'll hold it shut. Then this actually was a tag off of some olives. Can you believe that? But the shape was so great. So I cut one of these pictures. This is a lady's diary from Graphic 45, I believe. And another little gem from Manuela. I've been going through things that I've been hoarding, thinking you can't hoard them anymore. I put a heart on it because I love my niece so much. And a little coffee cup because we share our coffee together, but we haven't been able to do that since this social distancing thing. So that's my closure. And before I show you anything else, I want to show you this part. This is how the book came. It came with all of these papers that are already kind of stained and tea-dyed look. But I didn't want to just give her a book with this. So I have pulled some out to use as inserts. I've glued some pages together. I've folded some up. I'll show you as I go through. But I left all of this, these many, so that she can decide if she wants me to continue the book the way it is, if she wants to leave all of these just to make notes for herself. She does a lot of quilting and sewing, and I thought maybe she would like a place to put snippets of what she's done, so for future reference she could go back and say, oh yeah, that's how I did that. On the front I have various things I have pulled out of my stash. This is some Graphic 45. Some of these are Meg's Garden. Oh my goodness, and I don't know what any of the others are. This is a Tim Holtz, the Scrabble pieces, and I've used this stain stuff, my friend, not that one. That one's a Perfect Pearls. I use this Distress Mica spray. Man, do I love this stuff. Sometimes I painted it or dribbled it on, but look at the difference it makes. I hope I can show it. Yeah, look at here. It creates a gorgeous look on there. So I have some of these pull out, like this one. Some of them are just glued. I made a pocket and attached them to it. I just had lots of fun using up my bits and pieces. This one, oh, these are all attached just for pretties. This one comes out, and then I have a note in there that says, read me, and that explains what I have done here. This corrugated back here is just a cardboard box that I ripped apart and tore the, you know, the waffling in the inside out of. I did put just a little bit of glossy accents on her hat, and that's it for the front. I thought this collage was just perfect, especially with the band that goes around it. So when you open it up, I think this is a fashionista paper. I told you I went way back and pulled everything I could because she loves the Victorian, oh, what do I want to call it? the Victorian vintage type of look and the ladies. So I figured she'd really like this. I didn't do anything else because I didn't want to spoil this paper. Here, this envelope was included, and I almost took it out because I thought, oh, I don't know if I like this wonky envelope. And then I thought, but I like the colorings were perfect. So I put a collage on it. I have a little Timmy Holtz stick pin thingy in here. And it says, open me. And I have this teeny tiny little envelope. And then happy birthday with a little note from her auntie in here. But isn't that pretty? And now to close this, I've just left my lace up a little bit and can tuck it right underneath there like that. And then when you turn it, and like I said, I've just collaged different pieces. You can see that I've used, let's see if I can get this up here. This is what I wanted to show you. And you kind of see the gleam here. That's some of these, I use Perfect Pearls and Cappuccino. I use the Distress Mica Sprays. I use this old one from, 2013. This is Art Anthology. It's a warm. Oh, I just went through. Oh, here's another one I use. This is Lindy's Stamp Gang. This one is Blazing Sun. So I just did up a bunch of them and used the washes on all of these to change them to the colors that I wanted. Let me turn my phone off there. Then when you turn it, this envelope, I didn't put anything in here yet, but it has a spot that she could put receipts or pictures or whatever. And another little collage here of all different things. I think the butterfly and some of these are from Meg's Garden. Because she has such beautiful things. You know, go and check Meg's Garden out. I used to do design work for her. And the kicker was she's in Australia, so it costs so much to ship. But Meg has a bunch of downloadable things now. I'll leave a link below to her website. So it's instant download, much more cost friendly and really good where we're all doing this social distancing thing right now. So here's the next page. This paper, my friend Paula, excuse me, sent me, I think at Christmas time or my birthday, I don't remember which. This great, it's called Gypsy Gypsy. And this is, who is this? Craft Consortium. Oh my goodness, I love this paper. It's just absolutely gorgeous. Paula knows what I'm like, man. I just, oh, this is beautiful. So I used some of it, and that's what this pink is here. Here, oh goodness, I wish, here it is. Boy, wasn't that lucky. I took this piece of ribbon. It's like a gauze, I can't think. My brain's on overload this morning. But it's really, really sheer ribbon. And I just backed it with some sequin tape. And then I put it down. Now, it is tight enough mesh that the sequin tape does not come to the front and make it sticky. So if you've got something like that, this is a great way to stick something down and have it really stay put and in a nice line. My hint is, when you're doing ribbons this way with a sequin tape, only take a small portion of it, put it down where you want it, and then just begin, keep putting and peeling the tape as you go. Otherwise, if you pull the whole strip off and you begin to stick it down and the ribbon is kind of loose and will move, once it's stuck, then you're going to have this. So that's my tip. This is some old vintage lace strip that my niece had given me in one of her estate sale finds she found. This is an extra sheet of the paper that I pulled from the back. And I don't know what this is from. I can't remember. And here's just a little strip of the paper that came off of this that I edged it with. Now when you turn it, and now like I said, I've taken two or three pages and glued them together so they're nice and sturdy. So if you have any kind of book at home that you kind of like to alter, this is a great way to do it. I watch Diana Smith, Scrap Queen. Do you watch her? If you don't, there's another one. You need to go watch her. Her and Bunny Bo and Meg's Garden. These are great crafters. Great to fill your what am I going to do today because I'm stuck at home. You know, go watch these people. But Diana, she had taken an Arteza book and she glued the pages all together and flipped them up and down and all this stuff. And I thought, Oh, that's really a great idea. So when I spotted this ledger, I instantly thought of the videos that she shared doing that. So thanks, Diana, for the inspiration. Here's another piece of the lace that I put down, a strip of the paper. I did put two photo mats here, and I keep, you guys know what I'm like. I keep all these ings and offcuts, and I happened to find this little container, and it had these flourishes that I cut, and they were just perfect. I inked them with some, let me get this thing here. I inked them with some pink ink and some brown ink, and then these are just fussy cut from the paper, the little roses to adorn it more. But can you see? It isn't a lot. But it sure pops off when you're looking right on the page. These little things are Tim Holtz, and they were a gift from somebody, I'm not sure who. And I just took the corners here and put them down because they look like metal, but they're not real thick or heavy. Now, on this one, I took the page and I folded it this way. So here's the page, and I folded it in, corner rounded, inked around it, and I took a piece from that. Crafters, excuse me, consortium pad, and put the line piece here. The postcard, I'm not sure where this came from. And then I folded it back like this. And so when you open it, excuse me, you have this whole great big neat place to write or put pictures or whatever you want. And then it folds up. Now the postcard is actually my stopper. So it flips over and holds this in place. And that's just gluing the pages together again and using them still intact in the book. When you fold it over, look at this one. Isn't that just, I love this picture. And these are just, again, as I said, I'm sure that this is Meg's garden, and I think this is too. I'm not sure about the picture. That may be hers too. But I have attached all of these things. I left this up. What do I have here? My goodness. Just a minute, guys. Let me find. Oh, here we go. Let me find something here. I left this up so you can slide something behind it here. And I left it free here and put a little one of the. This is some paper. Oh, goodness. I can't remember. Shabby Dabby Licious or whatever her name is. I guess I better put a link to her too. But I watched somebody, and I think it was her. She did her tea-dye papers, and she used a brush and brushed them on. And I thought, ooh, I like that. So this is kind of a mishmash of coffee or tea and distress ink and the micas and everything else that I used to brush on my paper. And I hope, I don't know, I think you can see a little bit of the glimmer, but it's got that mica that shines through it. That is just super. So this just sticks back behind for an extra little note. On this side, I have two more of the photo spots, and I gotta tell you, I'm really, 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 really unhappy because I use matte medium. I see people using this all the time, and it looks so pretty, and well, I either put it on too heavy or I didn't spread it out well enough, but I have horrible bumpities, and I left the pages in because I wasn't going to ruin them and take them out, but I'm not happy with it. Glad it's going to my niece because she will be very forgiving. Here's two more. This is packaging off of a Tim Holtz packaging. These are some of the chit chat, the little sticker chit chats. It says, "When you know better, do better." And these are graphic 45 ladies that I cut out, oh my goodness, eons ago. And I sat one evening and just fussy cut them all out. And they've been back probably for 3, 4, 5 years, sitting in a little package, waiting for the perfect day to use them. This was it. This is some more lace here, just a doormat. You can't slide anything under it. On this side, I did a cluster of a postcard, a little envelope that I've made, a ticket stub, another one of these. This came from Bunny Bow, I believe, from Manuela. This is Meg's garden, and again, I have another one of these sheets that I tea-dyed, just stuck behind the envelope and behind here. But there's lots of room. You could put a lot of stuff in here. Now, this This came from my friend Cheryl Wells. And if you follow me, you'll remember quite some time ago, she sent me some different laces. Well, some of them, which is this one and another one I'll show you, were from her mom's hand crocheted lace and her mom's tatting. Well, those are really precious to me because she would share something that meant so much to her. Well, Cheryl knows Leslie. They are friends as well. So I know Cheryl's going to be tickled to death that her mom's laces ended up on a project for Leslie. Leslie's going to be thrilled that she's getting Cheryl's mom's laces. So hey, what a win-win situation. When I glued these pages together, I left them open so that I had an end, a huge mat, and that's where I put that lace on. This is some more of that gypsy paper, but it was lined and tea stained. All I did was ink around the edge, and that goes right in this end mat, and then the edge just folds over here with the lace on it. And here is the other piece of lace here, but here is the tatting. Here's a big mat here, and I did this double with a piece of I think graphic 45 paper here, and then I put the tatting along the edge. Love it. And this created a pocket here, and I did create a thumb spot on this side so you could pull the mat out. Another one of the graphic 45 ladies, and I don't know what this came from. I had this and this just cut out that I fussy cut. And these, I can tell by the feel of them, they have some decoupage or Mod Podge or collage podge probably over the top. So they're real sturdy. This again is packaging from one of my Tim Holtz packages. I have a little sticker here that says, "Life doesn't have to be perfect to be wonderful." And this I have stained again with all of those mica and the stains. And then I just tucked them in. So this is still free. Whatever she decides to put here is free, so it can slide underneath. She'll get the border, but then the flowers will be between, and there's still room to write in each corner. But, and this is a little glossier paper because this is packaging paper, but that was kind of fun too. Leslie will love it. And on these two, then I glued my pages together, then I folded them both back to create the pocket. They are glued here and across the bottom. Now here on both sides, I created a huge mat. This paper is quite thin, so I backed each one with some of my tea stained paper. And there's just a little flappy do here so that you can stick a picture or whatever underneath that to hold it. And it's really pretty when it slides in the slot here. Now, something else I did was I left this free. So you've got this whole space to write a secret note up here or to write something and then put a picture here, whatever. Instead of gluing it down and lose it, I just left the whole thing free. And on this side, I did identical to that. Here's another one of the huge giant mats. And it slides behind. Now my problem was, because I'm using up scraps, I only had one sheet of this paper. And there was no way to get these angles out of a 12 by 12 paper. So I ended up with a spot right here that was naked. There was no paper on it. So what I did, I had this fussy cut two ladies. So I just put them there. Now you tell me, would anybody ever know that I was missing something? So on this side, that's why I put the little flower over here so that it has cutouts. And then I found this lady and I knew I had to put her somewhere. So I just put her here, left her hat free. So again, I have this full page and I just put a crease across here so that when this folds up, it's creased, but you don't notice it when it's open, but it will fold up nicely. You don't have any bumps or anything. And then that just slides behind her hat. And it says down here, "Hold tight and pretend it's a plan." And that's the last page that I did. Now I'm kind of hoping Leslie says, "Yes, Auntie, take it back and do these pages too." Well, I couldn't do them all because it would make the book too thick, I think. But I have lots of ideas for this. but I want that to be her option. Maybe she'll like this for just writing or journaling or putting notes about what she's making or who knows. But I want it to be her option. But if she sends it back to me and allows me to do the rest of these pages, then I'll come back with another video later and show you what I made. This is the back inside cover. And I forgot to show you on the front, but I want you to see up here, because this was just like a chipboardy look. So I took my stains and I just inked all around the edge, and you can see that I did it on the front edge too, underneath there. Now it goes much better with the outer cover, and you don't have that grayy chipboard looking. This was really a modge podge of things. I had this paper in the back and it had this cutout piece, but then I had this piece of this lady that was just this part that I loved. But when I glued her down, you could still see part of that. So I took some of this cheesecloth and stained it and stuck that around. Then I had a pocket. Let me show you these. These are plain white envelopes that I sat one day and I tea stained and inked them all. I haven't done all of them, but that's what the base is behind that is holding all of these goodies. Now, some of them come out like these. This one, I guess quite a few of these come out like that. And you can see I folded it up at the bottom. This, and then had the two areas to go into. And I put more of these fussy cut ladies, some little stickers I had. This is another piece of crocheted lace that Leslie found at an estate sale. So see, she gives the things to Auntie, but one way or another, she sometimes gets them back. So I just made these tags. They just stick in here like this. This is another one that I've just stained and inked. I just had really a lot of fun. You know, when you're stressed, as most of us are right now, because the world is such a strange place, and I'm a touchy-feely person. I like to go up to my friends and family and give them a big hug and all this stuff. And you can't do that right now. And I'm finding it very, very difficult. So making and playing with all these little papers and everything is really kind of a calm to the storm that's going on around us. So that's what led up to this. I had this little, another one of these little envelopes. This is made out of, parchment paper, a roll of parchment paper that I get from Costco. I used to get to Costco. I'm not going to Costco anymore either. But anyway, and another one, I think this is Meg's Garden, another one of her little doodads. And then a little bitty tiny piece of lace. I have this little bitty, just this little snippet of a wire, beaded wire that I had. And then I left this open so that could go behind. And I just tucked this in because I love it. And I can't remember where I had it. I thought I had it there. Nope, had to have had it stuck in here somewhere like that. But that's the back cover. So if you have anything like this or an old book, doesn't have to be a ledger, use an old book and glue your own lined paper or something on it. But this was fun. This was fun. And this accumulated or used up a lot of these collage things that I've been making and playing around with. And I'm sure that she's going to like it. But see, if I do the rest of the book, I'm definitely going to have my elasticized closure, because the book will begin to alligator more, which most of us crafters don't care because we like all the goodies that are inside. So this is what I have. This is my share. I know it's been forever, friends, and I apologize for that, but you know, it's the way of the world. It's life right now. So take care, stay safe, and see you next time. Don't forget to go in your craft room and do something fun. Get your mind off of all the chaos in the world. Bye-bye now.